competitor number 8, the great Arcini. Arcini the Magnificent, but you're never going to get famous with a name like that. Don't worry about that, by the way, that's a nervous condition. I'm on tablets for it, I just took them too late in the dressing room. Look at that, one of them's kicked in. You're not bothering, you see that? It's a side effect. Anyway, we haven't got time, we've got a lot to get through. And I brought a few things with me to show you, and it's gone out, we're alright, I didn't need it. If at any point during the evening, you should hear this noise. And I don't want anybody to panic, because it'll probably be me playing with that. Write this all the way through, sir. This is the act. I'm on now. Are you German? No? There's sometimes some in. I just thought I'd run down. I brought this with me. This is nice. Watch this. There you go. It's an earwig. You see, it's on the top of my head like a wig, so I call it an earwig. It's actually a centipede, but centipede wig never used to get a laugh. Earwig didn't get a lot, did it? I'll tell you what. I like this one, watch. Surely this man was the son of God. Oh, sorry, that was a centurion. I've got something in here that you very rarely see, unless you go to magic conventions. And, it's very, very interesting. I brought it all the way with me. Very rare. You hear about them, but you never see them. It's in here. This is unusual. This has got carving on it. It says down here, in ancient hieroglyphics, apparently 8 out of 10 owners say their cats prefer whiskers. And the other 2 shave the cats. I can't wait. I haven't got time. Apparently 2 out of 10 people said if you lost some fog, it would be missed. Says it on here. 3 out of 10 people think a gladiator is a happy Roman. The German one got it there, just. And apparently, 9 out of 10 archaeologists think their life's in ruins. I said you've never seen one before, it's an opinion poll. It's gonna be a long night, there's another 4 acts like me to come after this. We'll try something else. Try something here. That's it, you sit with the camera around your neck, that's it. Yeah, you. Give me any number at all between 1 and 50.
25.
You, sir. Any number at all. Anyone at all, just any number at all between 1 and 50. 5. I try it, woman. Madam, that's it. Your baby? Just wondered, just a question, don't worry. Any number at all between 1 and 50. 7. It's going to take ages, this, isn't it? I'd have won if I had worked. If I had worked, I'd have won the competition, but anyway. What a try, isn't it? See that? That's a carrier pigeon. See, so it's got a handle on the top, so I call it carrier pigeon. Carry a pigeon. French, possibly. French? I've totally lost him. Keeps grinning at me, really, so... We'll try something a little bit different, I think. The power of the mind, because that's what I wanted to do tonight. A little thing using the power of the mind. You, sir, in the orange shirt, that's lovely. What I'd like you to do is to concentrate on any colour at all, any colour you like, a nice bright colour, vivid colour, flying from a flag, high on a building. Max Maven taught me that. And just sort of waving, rafting about from a very tall building, a bright colour. Just concentrate on that colour, okay? I'm going to attempt to write it down here. This is brilliant, this. I've never done it before, but I've seen somebody else, and it's brilliant. Okay, sir, are you thinking of a colour?
Yes.
Yeah, you're thinking of a nice, bright, vivid colour. For the first time, sir, shout out the colour you're thinking of.
Orange.
Orange. What's wrong with red? Everybody else thinks of red. Never mind. You, sir, with the glasses, have you got with you a box of matches?
No.
There you go, then. Magic in for the judges now. Well, that's the first time that's happened. Looks good from up here. Right. I'm having a bit of bad luck because I do have it's tablets again. I do have bad luck, and I got a job as a rocket, and I was fired on the first day. I went to the fishmongers, I said, I'd like a cod's head for the cat. He said, we don't do transplants. I went into a vegetarian restaurant, I said, I'd like veg and 2 veg. He said, I'm sorry, the veg is off. I said, forget it, I'll just have veg. I was hiding behind a hedge, playing the drums, and a policeman came and arrested me for beating about the bush. You can try and clap, right? I know it's difficult to write them down at the same time, but have a go. I said, I'd like an estimate. He said, you're about 6'1". That wasn't a trick, it was just a flash in the pan, but I thought I'd give it a go. I don't know, I won't pick on you. You, sir, yeah, with a very distinguished moustache. Face doesn't match, but just, yes. What I'd like you to do is to think of any name at all, a Christian name, just an English Christian name, something I can spell, preferably. Okay? Just concentrate on it very, very hard. Right? Just concentrate on that name. You could have chose a shorter one, but never mind. Okay, I think I've got it. Sir, what is the Christian name you are thinking of?
Chumley.
Pardon?
Chumley.
Chumley? Yeah, right, we've got to move on. I actually do this for a living, you might find that hard to believe, but I do. But in my spare time, I don't make a lot of money, in my spare time I'm a private detective. Last week I solved my first murder case, happened in an old English mansion. The lady of the house had been killed. So I went straight round to the house to help the police. I went round the back of the house and I found a clue. Lying in the grass underneath a broken window, I found this. Straight away I knew the murderer had got in using a crowbar. 17 quid, it's a very expensive club. I went into the library and the lady of the house was lying dead in the library. Next day I found this weapon. Straight away I knew she'd been poisoned. But on examining the clues, I worked out that she'd been murdered by the butler. And I'll prove it. Listen to this.
murder.
There you go. You see, the evidence speaks for itself. On my sheet, I have written orange. Slow down while the lights are going out. Sir, you thought of a name, Chumley. I wrote Chumley. You picked the six of hearts, sir, and I have written down here the six of hearts.
Gentlemen,